Yo guys, what's going on? This is Yorkie Man here. Welcome back to another episode of this Football Manager 2021 save here with Sevilla. And we finally managed to get things clicking with the tactic and turn form around a little bit. As you can see, we're in third in the table. We have played some big games as well, but we play the league's top goal scoring side this season. Well, they've got the top goal scorer in their team in Jose Morales with 9 goals. We're not even on the list, boys. We're not even on the list, which is a little bit frustrating. But we have spread the goals around the team this season, so that's absolutely fine. We're going to be taking on Levante today in this one. I thought that was a good point. We've played quite a few games. We are in January. We've made one. I nearly did 2 signings. We've made 1 signing. We've been looking at some other players. The non-EU thing got me a little bit. We nearly had ourselves a new striker in Rafael Santos Borr, but unfortunately for me, he fit in the non-EU category. I was praying when I looked at his information that he had a second nationality, but it just wasn't to be. So he was going to be the new goal scorer. He was going to be the new striker, but we couldn't bring him in. We're still looking at players and looking to move players out as we go along now because the squad is a little bit bloated and now I've got to play with the team for about 20 or so games. I kind of know who's going to be in my squad and who's not. But before we meet the new signing, let's see how we've been getting on. Probably the first thing to note that we should talk about is the Europa League draw, and it's quite a difficult one. I think Red Bull Salzburg are a very good side. They're very good in this competition, although they're not as good as we are in this competition, and I think we'll be able to get past them. There's still some big sides left in it, and this is the first knockout round. There is a second knockout round as well. I think the system's changed in the Europa League, although it might not have done it this season. So there's still some big teams in there. There's some big teams we're going to come up against, I imagine, as we go further on. But when I look at all the sides there, I do make us favourite if we have a good run. I do make us favourite because we're a good enough team. So Salzburg, the side we're going to be taking on over 2 legs, I worry about them because they've got some pace in their side. They've got some good players. We are looking at Woba actually at the minute as a potential centre-back signing. I just like him. I think he's a good player at 22-year-old. So we're looking at him, but there's no guarantee that we'll get him in. We are kind of blessed at centre-back at the moment. I quite like it. But the worry for me is they've got players like Patson Daka up top, who's absolutely rapid, who could get in behind. And that's really where we concede our goals. You'll see now that we've conceded most of our goals when teams get in behind. So since the Leipzig game, we've not actually lost a match, which is insane because we played Barcelona and Atletico Madrid in this run, and we haven't lost a match yet. And we've had some luck, but we've had some good performances. We kicked it off by beating Real Betis 3-1. We had a 6-2 in the cup against River Melita. Not a clue, but we beat them. Then we played Atletico Madrid. Now, Atletico Madrid was always going to be a tough game. In fact, a game I was expecting to lose, especially being away. But we actually put in a solid performance. And when I say solid performance, we just nullified them. We did nothing going forward. We were awful going forward. But we stopped them doing anything going forward. Then we played against Real Valladolid. And this is where we've changed the tactic. We play one against the big sides, or the sides that I'm expecting could be a difficult game, and then one against sides that I expect us to beat, and especially when we're at home. And all it is a swap between a DM and a cam. I mean, our instruction-wise is very similar to what it was before, a little bit of a hybrid press, but we are now going to the situation where when we play against the bigger sides, i.e. the Barcelonas, we are playing with a DM. But against these smaller teams where, you know, I'd noticed here we struggled, we're going to up it to a cam, which gives us a little bit more attacking impetus. We then went on and beat Celta Vigo 2-1. This was a really good result because Celta Vigo's squad, although they're underperforming in the league, you'll see they're having a dreadful season in the league. In reality, I think they're, what, the 17th, which is insane. Their team is actually very good, and they've got players in their side that could cause you a few problems if they get forward. So I was a little bit worried about it, but it was a good performance, actually, all round. It was a really good performance and a good victory for us. We then took on Barcelona, and this was an unbelievable game for me. Because being at home, you always think you have the advantage, but we were the better side. Barca weren't very good. In fact, they scored with their first shot on target, and then we dominated. And at one stage of the game, at 1-1, I went up to a cam because I thought they're here for the taking, and unfortunately, we just could not find that second goal to get ourselves a big win here against one of the top sides. Now, I'm assuming this season, season one, Barca just aren't that good, and they're going to get better and better as time goes on. Now, I'm assuming they're still under this crippling debt in this save because we did use an update. I'm imagining that they've done that to them. And we're going to be interested to see actually what happens with Barcelona, because I could see them not being a top 2 side in the next few seasons. I mean, they're currently second, but we're only 3 points behind them. And Real Madrid aren't a great side this year either. So I'm very interested to see what happens with them. Do they re-sign Messi? What happens additions to the team. It's an aging side. Will they progress? And will this actually become a little bit easier for us to try and attack them? You can see already they don't really have a budget this season, although they are going to have tremendous wages if Messi does leave next season. We then played against Ponferradina, and this is what happens here. William Gubels, Rakitic. Rakitic has been brilliant, and it's making me worry on how we replace him now. Now, I looked at Gini Wijnaldum to be Rakitic's replacement, and we just couldn't come up with a contract. Rakitic would have to leave for me to have the money then to pay for Wijnaldum. So Rakitic may be extended for a year. We did it with players in the Man City save. We extended Aguero because he played so well. Rakitic, even at his age, is performing fantastically for me, so I think we will extend his deal. William Gubel's getting his first goal for the club, which, you know, I was really excited. He's been playing out on the left wing. I'm not playing him up top. I'm playing him out on the left wing. And I'm excited to see what the young Frenchman can do. This is a great opportunity for him. Now, at 19, he does need game time, so I'm trying to start rotating him into the squad, because if I'm 100% honest, I'm not the biggest fan of our wingers, which is crazy because on paper they look good, but for me they're just not performing good enough. And William Gubels bags himself his first goal, so I was really happy with that. And then obviously the most recent result was a 4-2, and again the issue for me is the thing that we're conceding goals, which is kind of okay because we're winning games, we're outscoring teams, but we are conceding goals. Now this was a very good performance, but this really does highlight one of my biggest issues in Football Manager. Now, I'm not going to pick apart and go through every game. They had 3 shots on target and they scored 2. And they weren't great opportunities. They've got an XG of 0.41. So we already know they're not very good opportunities that they're scoring from. This happens in most games. And in most of the goals, you'll see us conceding. We dominated the game. We might have given our opposition 1 or 2 shots and they score them. So I'm hoping that stops. The more and more the team get used to this, the more and more that we grow and get better. I think we do need a better sweeper keeper, because I'm enjoying the way we play out of the back. The speed in which the midfield can move the ball about is nice. It's nice to watch, but the goalkeeper isn't... He's not the best, but he's good enough for now. Naziri scoring again. Oscar Rakitic with a pen. He scored a few. And a youngster, who we should mention, getting his first senior goal for the club in his first start for the club. He started in a cup game. His first start in the league. Unbelievable, this kid. 17. Now, I was, at first sight, I was like, right, okay, cool. What we'll do is we'll train him. He could be a right winger. And we'll retrain him to play inside forward or something. But with 6 finishing, he's probably never, ever going to be an inside forward. And then I was thinking about how important that Navas has been to this side. Navas has been pivotal and he's been great for me in this save. But God, is he old. So, Gianluca, he's the new Navas. I'm telling you now, he's the new Navas. Yes, we need to improve his tackling and his marking. They will get better. We need to improve his work rate, because I need his work rate up there. But at 17, he's the most promising player that we've got at the club right now to replace Navas. So that's what we're doing. He's being retrained as a wing back. We're working on it. We're going to try and improve him. But he's getting game time now, which definitely should boost him. And the club already reckon that he could be a superstar for us in the future. I'm excited. Gianluca could be the one. Gianluca could be the saviour. Because it was going to be really hard, because Navas's attributes are unbelievable. It was going to be, you're looking at 40 million to try and replace what Navas gives to the club. This kid, free. Well, he's not free, is he? But academy player. I'm excited. We'll see how he gets on, though. So this is the tactic, and the only change really is that we swap to a DM and the 2 centre mid roles change a little bit. Now, we're ball winning and box to box. Ball winning is nailed on. It happens. We're always going to use that. There has been tweaks, though. The box-to-box, I've played Playmaker there. I've played box-to-box, I've played Mazzala. I've just played centre-mid. We're trying box-to-box at the minute. I don't know if it's going to work. We might have to turn it around. Rakitic isn't the best at that, but just having him on the pitch in some capacity for Sevilla is always going to be a bonus. Set pieces, corners, throw-ins, penalties. He bags them all. So having him on the pitch, just in some capacity, is very important to the squad. But I'm not sold on this at the moment. I'm not, but we're getting there. We are getting somewhere, and the team certainly is improving. So the only player we brought in was a loan signing. It was Adrian Marin. You look at him and you probably go, he's not very good though, is he, Yorkie? But We needed a left back. We've been playing Valsic there for the majority of the time because Marcus Acuna just keeps on picking up injuries, which is horrendous for me because it's the last thing we need. And he's really important to the way we play going forward. But yeah, he just keeps picking up injuries. I mean, he's got himself another injury right now. How long's he out for? He should be back in 2 to 5 weeks. He's in the rehab stage. It's been a constant. I think this is his fourth injury so far. And when you look at how many games he's played, he has played 13 in about 25 games, maybe 26 games if you count the cups. Two cup games and 6 Champions League games and then the 17 or so league games. So he's brilliant. I love him. He's going to be fantastic if he just keeps himself fit. And if he doesn't keep himself fit at the moment, we really don't have tons in the left-back position. So it was more just cover. We've been very sensible with the transfers in this save so far because we've signed a couple of young players and then we haven't really been able to do much. They spent 49 million and we sold a couple of players. But Yassine Banal, the goalkeeper, he went for 5 million. And Sergio Escudero went as well. So we sold a few players. And when I look at it, we've got players to come back. Alex Robles, Ronnie Lopez, Idrissi. Especially Ronnie Lopez and Idrissi are players I actually really like. The Portuguese man. And Idrissi was great for me on last year's game. So I've got fond memories of him. And he looks very talented. So we've got these players to come back as well. The good wingers. The very good wingers. Both him and Ronnie are very good wingers. So one for each side. So I'm excited to have those back. It frustrates me that they're out on loan. But I understand we're a little bit rushed at wing at the moment. We've got too many. We've got Ocampos. We've got Gomez. Munier can play on the wing. Suso. There's a lot of players that can play on the wing. But then a lot that aren't doing it now. Gomez has been okay, but he's not been the superstar I wanted him to be. But 4 goals and 4 assists, he is getting there, but he's not been the superstar I want him to be. And he's on one of the bigger wages at the club as well, which makes it a little bit of a problem. But we're getting there. So Karim Rekic has been playing a lot at left back. It is not his favourite position. He would much prefer to be played as centre back. And our biggest issue is he's not good enough. He's not. He's doing a good job, but he's not good enough. And he's often come up with poor performances. As you can see, when the team's playing fantastically, he's often come up with the one that's been poor in the performance. And we have a few players that are being touted toply. Koundé, obviously you'd expect it, and Carlos. Vidal looks like he's on his way out. We had a little bit of a rumble. We had a little bit of a falling out. And in my brain, I'm going, I've got Navas and now I've got Junalu, who I want to give the game time. So I'm happy for him to go. Him being here just stands in the way of Junalu's, you know, progression. But Diego Carlos, I really don't want to go unless the correct fee comes in. And I want like 40 million because teams like Man United and Liverpool are coming in for him. And Koundé's just no, please nobody sign Koundé. And if they do, it's going to have to be the release clause, which I believe on Koundé is pretty high. If we look at the contract info, yeah, 73 million. So it's going to have to be big money to sign him because he's by far the best centre-back at the club. But let's get into this cup game now against Levante. Let's see if we could progress. Now, the reason why I came back for this one was I just felt like it was a good game to come back for. We're in the middle of January, so I knew we were going to have a few bits and bats to cover. And in this first season, I want to try and start getting through stuff as quickly as possible. We'll probably, again, after this, we'll go a little bit further forward and maybe do the Getafe game. I'm not always just going to bring the big games because at this stage, The big games aren't going to be great because we're probably, wow, this is a tough month, it's February for us. Very tough running. It's Sociedad, Villarreal, Valencia, Real Madrid, then the double Salzburg, Athletic Bilbao. I mean, I'm learning now that we've definitely got a good enough squad to keep up pace. And top four is all we need this season. But yeah, I don't want to always just bring the big games. I find that a little bit boring myself because you're just going to see me play Real Madrid, Barcelona two times every seat. Like, there's just no fun in that for me. So Levante today in the cup, and a cup competition I'd like us to do well in, but you're going to get to see a little bit of the youth today, some of what we've got to offer in the squad. We'll also notice this. Everybody in the Sevilla seaside has told me that they want a new contract, and they're all trash, and they all keep coming to me. I get a message every day. Gaffer, in my office, so-and-so wants a new contract. I look at them and I'm like, why would I ever give you a new contract? So that's a little bit frustrating. This is going to be the team we put out here for the Levante game. Now, I have rotated a little bit, but again, I do want to go through. So we've got some of the stronger players in, but Fernando's going to come in at box-to-box. Peglo's going to stay there at We've also brought in Diego Carlos as well. It could backfire on us. It's not the end of the world if we got knocked out in the cup, but I'd like to go as far as we could go. You know, if some of the bigger teams get knocked out, which you never know, we've seen it before in cups, it's a good opportunity for silverware this season, is this trophy. Although I do think we can go very deep into the Europa League, fingers crossed, don't get knocked out by Salzburg. I think it makes sense for us to try our best here to try and maybe pick up the Copa del Rey as well, or at least be in the equation to pick up the Copa del Rey. Now, we kind of struggled in the last round. That was with full rotation. I will come back off a 2D for you guys, because I know you probably don't want to see 2D. We'll go sideline. But yeah, in the last one, I felt like we did full rotation, and it didn't fully work, if we're being honest with ourselves. It didn't fully work. Because we struggled a little bit. Although we dominated the game, we struggled with cutting edge. We should have the cutting edge in this one, though. There's enough quality players on this pitch to stand up and give Levante a problem, as Gomez there is dribbling, really took him forward. The issue with that is I'm looking at Idrissi and saying he's going to come in and be a natural replacement, potentially, for Gomez, but in reality, probably not. He probably won't be, because Gomez is very good. I think he just lacks the energy for a full 90 minutes when we're trying to play as aggressively as we are. We tried to turn this side into someone who could play this aggressive style of football, because the passing play that we were trying at the start of the save, just it wasn't yielding us any success. We were dominating games, but in reality, we weren't scoring any. We're going to get a penalty here, and this is where I probably wish Rakitic was on the pitch. So Ocampos is going to take it. He won it, so he takes it. Hopefully he nestles this in the back of the net. And he does. He's got a yellow card already, but that'll be 1-0 Sevilla. And I'm pretty happy with that. While we're at it, boys, if you're around here, please hit subscribe. Smash the like button. And how are you getting on with the update? I've seen mixed reviews, but I'm not noticing much different. I've got to be honest with you. Since the update, I'm not really noticing anything different about the game. It seems very similar to me than what I was playing before. It's nice that we now get assists. You know, it's nice that we now get assists. The ball has bounced about in there and Gadez just couldn't get the power on it. It's nice that we've now got assists. What we could do with looking for, coming into next season, this is, we probably won't find anyone of the quality in this window. I will maybe take a look on the transfer list. I haven't yet. Is we need another ball-winning midfielder. You know, that physical dominating player there in centre mid, you know, your Kante. We're not going to get a Kante, but you know, that style of player. And Naziri gets another goal. That's his 8th of the season. Another assist for Gomez, but I think Gomez was probably going for it there and just, I don't know, it landed to Naziri. So 2-0 up, which is nice, because I didn't expect this, to be honest with you. I didn't expect this. I thought Levante would be very difficult, free at the back. They're playing a very difficult formation for us to deal with. And it's going well. We're actually going to go on key highlights, because I've babbled on a little bit in this episode. But yeah, we could do that physical player, because Gadej is great there. Don't get me wrong, but he's all we've really got. If he can't play there, it's kind of like, who are we going to play in that position? And then we don't use it. And I feel like the way we're playing at the moment, we need one of those midfielders in this squad at all times that will just do the dirty work. I think a lot of teams need that, but we definitely need it. And he's the man for us at the moment. Well, to be fair, we've just noticed Torreira there at Atletico Madrid. He could be a man that's good at doing the dirty work with his 15 tackling. He will be going back to Arsenal next season. Maybe they don't want to keep him. We bring him in and he comes to Sevilla. He'd be the archetype of the type of player we're looking at, because he's got a great engine, great work rate, good work ethic. That's what we need. We're absolutely dominating this game, so we're going to take this opportunity to give people like Gomez a rest. We will get William Goebbels on. And what else will we do here? You know, Peglo's not had a great game, but I want him to have the game time. Same with Janilu. Not had a great game, but he needs the game time in the squad. I would love to bring Gadej off. It's just really don't have options. I would have to put Fernando there, who is average in that position. And we will bring on Vasquez, who is in the shop window. We'll also bring on Alcedo, the young left back. Just give them a run out, give them a bit of game time. Now, here in Spain, we get 5 subs. I don't know if that's just first season or if they've changed that in real life, so now we'll get that second season. But I suppose we'll cross that bridge when we get there. And since we went to key highlights, we've not had a highlight, but we don't need one because we're cruising through at the moment while resting some of our key players. And you can't ask for much more from a cup game. Not a single highlight that second half, but we got the goals we needed. And we got to rest a few players as well at the same time and give game time to others. So I'm happy with that one. Well done. Good win, boys. I'll take that any day of the week. Be interesting now just to see who we get in the next round. That's a really good result. Might advance forward, just want to see when the cup draw is. When the cup draw is. We have been looking at left-backs. There's a couple from Atletico Madrid. Manu Sanchez, I think that's it, from Atletico Madrid. He's a player I really like the look of, but it's convincing him to come with us. So Luke de Jong is someone we probably are going to have a serious conversation with, because at 30 years old, Euro's coming up, he'll want to be playing football. He's not going to get it here now. Nziri, for me, is number one, and then Meunier's been playing in front of him. I think we look to maybe sell Luke de Jong. I'll discuss the issue with him, and I'll broach the idea of us selling him. So I'm going to say we'll sell him. If I'm not going to play here, so we are going to sell him. We are going to sell him, but I think it makes sense. I wanted to really like Luke de Jong because I think he's a great player, but in terms of pace, he's no Nziri, and he's no Meunier either. So we will offer him out. We'll see if we get him money. I mean, there's already somebody interested in him, Sociedad, so I'm not going to take a short amount of cash, but we don't need the amount of strikers we've got at the moment, so maybe it makes sense to let him go. They've offered 9.5, and I kind of think in January, 9.5 for a striker that's not playing and doesn't want to be at the club is acceptable. So we will take that, and we'll just fill our pockets with a little bit more cash, because financially, the club's in a good position. It does say they're rich, but the better off we can be, it just works out well for us, because then they're going to give us more money in future seasons. We are going to get the cup draw in this episode, though. It's coming up in a second. So here we go, the fourth round, and there is nothing but big boys in this now. There's a few sides that we wouldn't mind facing. There also is some big hitters in there that we would prefer not to face. So Real Betis, a side I wouldn't mind facing. They've got Real Madrid. So that does eliminate two of the harder teams. Girona here, I would love them. Barcelona, though, that is great for us. Else we've got Getafe. We'll face Getafe then. Getafe are no slouch. Getafe are no slouch, but I think we can beat them. They do, coincidentally, have two left-sided players that I would love in Cucurella and Oliveira. But that's by the by. Getafe having a mid-table season. They have got Champions League in recent years. So they have been doing very well. But yeah, I fancy us against them. So hopefully that'll be us through. Is there any other really tasty signs? Not really, but you know, Real Madrid, Betis, you never know what's going to happen. Betis don't exactly have a terrible side, so it'd be interesting to see who's left after this. But yeah, that's going to be it for this episode, boys. I hope you enjoyed it. I know that the Football Manager stuff on the channel is not the most popular series, but I enjoy it. So I'm always going to put this content out there because I have a good time doing it. I'm enjoying this Sevilla save. I'm looking forward to seeing what we can do with the squad and how we build it, because we're doing all right now. It's always rough at the start, I think, and sometimes you have to take on an identity you might not have particularly wanted to at the start of the save. I didn't really want us to be a team that put pressure on sides and look to build up play actually very quickly, because we move the ball very fast through midfield up to the attack, and that's really what gets us most of our goals. But unfortunately, when you look at the squad more and more, it's the best way for us to play our football at the moment. But anyway, boys, I appreciate the support as per usual. If you're new around here, please hit subscribe, smash the like button, lads. It helps the videos do better, and I will see you in the next one.